I want to ask about the mindset, the emotional and mental toll that that year took on you. I can't remember what point this was, but there's a video of me after practice cussing out the Philadelphia media. I watched this for weeks.
Yeah.
When you got back from Kentucky, where they would come in as soon as they were allowed in after practice, and they'd all run to a certain spot, and they'd all point their iPhones or they'd point their cameras at you. And a lot of times you'd be shooting layups or shooting form shots. It was like the daily, what does Markelle's shot look like?
Mm-hmm.
And the reason I got mad that day was the body language. Like you were 19 at the time, dealing with an injury. And it felt like, and I've said this before, so I'm not knocking the Philly. Yeah. I know they got to cover it, but it felt like they were like vultures. And they had lost or ignored some of your humanity.
Yeah.
And I calmed down and I addressed it with them afterwards, but I did cuss them out. Mm-hmm. Deservedly so, by the way. For you, take me through that year from the time that, you know, you decide to sort of give your body a break and do the rehab process. It's a disappointing start, and now all of a sudden, you know, you've got to deal with this noise from the media.
First, thank you for that. You know, that was like another big brother moment that you stood up for me, and it made me feel even better. But you know, starting from all of the beginning, everything that I've been through, you know, of course, you know, being a professional and being an NBA at the highest level, and everybody knows Philly media is like known for, you know, being whatever you want to call it. You know, I didn't really, to me, I never got caught up in media, but it definitely was like you said, it was like every day was, you know, what is Markelle doing? And me, I was just, you know, being myself, I'm just trying to get better. I'm trying to figure my stuff out. But you're human. You notice everything. You see it in the background. You see them recording. And so it was like, it would just be crazy that, you know, it was crazy how the media just swore they knew everything that was going on. And they tried to, you know, put out this thing that I was changing my shot. I was doing this, that, and the third. And to me, it was always like, wow, I was like crazy. So many people think they know, you know, a narrative or what's going on in a situation, but have no clue. And it was like, it was always something new, you know, it was people saying, it was so much crazy stuff going on, you know, people saying I got a motorcycle accidents, you know, all types of things. And I would just crack up laughing like, dang, like this is what, you know, what is going on, and all from somebody, you know, starting something and somebody picking it up. So it was just like, I had to almost cleanse myself of looking at it, because not that it bothered me, like, and to the point like where I look at it, I'm like, oh man, I hate myself. I mean, I suck. I mean, how could people think of this? It was almost like after you start to see stuff so much on the internet, you kind of start to, it starts to mess with your mind a little bit. Like, fuck, like why the fuck are people always like thinking they know something? So it just got to the point where I had to like just stop looking at everything on social media and just literally lock into, you know, myself and what I had going on in the gym, because at the end of the day, basketball has always been something that's been an outlet for me. So it's always been something that, you know, no matter what my problems are going on off the court, anything else can be going on, when I step on the floor, it's like my sanctuary. I'm just happy. I have fun. And I think that's what you see on the floor. Like you said, when I'm in Orlando, you know, I just have pure joy and fun playing the game of basketball. So it was really like kind of trying to mess with my mind. It was just like something that continue to know that it's in the back of your head that people are saying this, that, and the third, but you know the truth, Kel. And I'm never the type to, again, I was 19. I wasn't the type to, you know, I'm gonna go to the media and talk back like, this isn't true. You know, this is all bullshit, because I had a bigger picture in my mind. So it was always just, you know, Kel, just continue to pray, continue to work. Everything else is, you know, going to take care of itself. But It's definitely something that, you know, if you don't have the right mental toughness and the right people around you to have the right mindset, the internet and media can mess up, you know, can mess you up big time. But that's something that I didn't allow to happen. But it was definitely something that was super tough, you know, never being in that position from my whole career. You know, I was came out of high school, you know, I was always, you know, the underdog, and I always had good stuff, you know, said about me. So to actually see like all this craziness on the internet about me, it was just like, this is what the big leagues are about. This is, you know, this is what they talk about when they say, you know, the media can change you. But, you know, it was crazy. But again, it's something that I learned from it. It made me stronger today.